Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika, and in this video we're going to talk about stars and how to edit them. Now, in order to explain this, so let's first talk about what we can't do before we can talk about what we can do. When working with Illustrator shapes, you know, there are some shapes, let's make a polygon, that you can edit later. So the polygon has this area in the transform panel, and there you can edit the shape. And you can later change the number of corners of this polygon. Let's delete this. Unfortunately, the same is not true for the star. So when I draw a star, it looks like this and no shape properties, because this is not a shape, this is just a path. And you can also create the star differently. You can just click with the tool and then you get this dialog box. And there we have the properties which you used to create it, which is two radii. We've got the inner radius and the outer radius. This is what makes the star. And when using this, you get a geometrically exact star. Let's cancel. Now, in order to edit this, you can somewhere read the tip to use the lasso tool and select these inner points, and then use the scale tool and scale this like some degrees. You see there's in the center of the star, there's the reference point, and then go to OK and you get the new star. Now this looks correct, but we will see that it isn't. So I'm going to deselect and then I'm going to turn on the smart guides and let's just measure. I'm going to draw a line from here to there and we see this is 42.045 millimeters. Let's take a look at this one and you see it has a different length, which it shouldn't if this were exact. So why isn't it? In order to find out, we need rulers and then let's just draw guides and draw another star. So the star is drawn from the center. So let's just place the tool in the center and drag out a star. There we have it. And I'm going to press the shift key in order to make this even. Like so. And now we're going to take a look at the bounding box. I'm going to the select tool and now it shows the bounding box. And you see this bounding box has its vertical center here, which is on the guideline, but the horizontal center is above the guideline. So the center which is used to scale these inner points is not the geometrical center of that star. That's why the method doesn't work. So how can we achieve what we want? In order to get that, we need to draw a different star. And that star can be drawn with the ellipse tool. Press the shift key and draw an ellipse. Like so, and let's give it the standard graphic style by pressing D. Now it just has a black stroke. And then we can apply effect distort and transform, zigzag, and make the points for the star. Here we set the richest per segment, and there you can set the size, and then you get an editable star. Unfortunately, you can't have any number of points on this star, but that's the only thing Illustrator offers, so that's it. There's a different method, and you can use Astute Graphic Tools, which is VectorScribe. It has dynamic shapes. You could use that as well, and there you could draw editable stars, and you can later edit the number of points, and you can edit the inner and outer radius. That's another method, but you need the plugin for it. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.